You know, we could go through a 100 different articles put out by the media every day, and it's more distracting to our mind than helping to form specific ideas about things. And we hear little bits of truth been put into other topics, like the oil disaster in the Gulf, little bits of it here and there, 100s of articles about it, of course. This is all to keep us distracted as well, because one never gets the real truth about anything. And all this distraction stops one from keeping his mind on track of where the world is going. Bypassing what's churned out by the authorized media, we find out what really is happening in the world. And we are going into this planned scientific new world order. And the elite seems to win. They won. Up until now, these guys have run much of the globe for the last 100 years. And they are afraid of people being able to organize themselves, who know their purpose, and who are not taken off by distractions, and who can prepare for the awful times coming. And a lot of people are prepared for the bad times coming. That is something that is good to hear. Because the majority of the public will never ever understand what's really happening. But it has never been the majority of the public that has changed anything at all for their own good either. It has always been a small minority who have educated themselves, who have guided themselves from going into a further disaster. And people should be planning to get through tough times right now. Tough times, as I say, massive taxation is coming down. Massive, massive taxation is all scheduled to replace the consumer society by fees and taxes. And we are going to be prepared for that. To be as independent as possible, as they will allow you to be, because they are going to put their fingers into everything now. And the time will come when we need licenses to even have a garden. In some countries you already got that. They don't want you to be independent. But don't stop doing it. Don't ever stop doing it. 44 to 32 please. Check out papers of the United Nations and all of their 1,000s and 1,000s of reports, from health to everything. You need to focus on to the RIA. The Royal Institute for International Affairs, of which Russell was a member, and then look into Chatham House to see their think tanks and what they are working on right now. You will see, think tanks are working on ways to get the society to accept things that we haven't even heard of right now. They haven't published it yet. Again, it's a technique they use to put things across. Most folks believe whatever they are told and comply. And really, in the US, if anything is to happen at all, it will start there. Even though the society is being totally debased by the culture creators, they still have a memory of what freedom is supposed to be. Once we forget that, we would not have even anything to refer to. So, for those in the US, keep up the good work, keep doing what you are doing, and let it be an example for the rest of the world too. There is not a lot that you can do in Canada. I am afraid they are pretty content with being happy slaves. Corporations tell the politicians what to do, and politicians consult with private firms like the RAND Corporation. All you have to do is own the RAND Corporation and you can influence the world and all the other corporations that deal in specialized areas. That's how the world is really run. And it has been for an awful long time. It's those guys who came up with all the ideas of a global society, what kind of society it would be, how they prepare our minds for the society. And how they would alter the cultures, and how you would have basically a multicultural society where no one marries eventually. No one, even with the ethnic groups too, after a generation or so. They don't marry either, they are right into the same system. A system that philosophers talked about for thousands of years. As Plato talked about it too, in his book, The Republic. The perfectly ordered eugenically controlled society where everyone shares all women in common. We now call it polymiscuity, but it's here. You didn't think that's what it was, did you? And the Matrix is this big system in which we are born. And it's pre-existent, of course, for every generation. We don't plan it, we are born into it. We are told to adopt and accept it. We are given whatever norms at the time and the culture, industry, the education system. All these things work together to create a form of reality for us. For our time only, because there is always a purpose behind that which they give you. It can be temporary because they have always got another step to go after that, and so on. Until they end up with the ideal society. A very obedient society, of course. In the meantime, there are demonstrations and groups demanding various things. That's all permitted to an extent. And it's really irrelevant because the big boys have never really listened to the crowds anyway. And they are certainly not listening to them today. And the crowd really think they are going to demand something and get it because they think they believe they are really living in a democracy. They haven't learned yet. They are not in a democracy. The term is a cover. It's always been used as a cover, and they are going away with it awfully well up to this present time. Many authors, including Quigley, talked about the fact that there are parties giving them a mouthing of difference. In other words, what comes from their mouth, this is what makes you think that this is right wing and this is left wing, and you don't watch what they do. And he says in both parties they are following the identical same road. And that's what we have today. One leaves, one takes over, same thing is carried on as before. What they say is completely different, but it's what they do that matters, not what they say. In 1952, Lord Bernard Russell wrote a book. It's called The Impact of Science on Society. And he talked about how this scientific system, a revolution, he called, would come into play.